Hello, this is Hana. Hana Harmony. I really want to read my Bible. Just after my elder son, the 1988, I gave a gift for his graduation. But now, anyway, during the almost 20 years, I wrote the last of Bible verse. From sometimes I felt, and sometimes others, pastors meeting, I just wrote it here. So I wanna keep it. This all of my Bible. As my treasure for my grandchildren, especially for my sons and daughter. This I made by my own diagram. I love to read and just meditate the creation from Genesis chapter 1. So please share with me. I'm trying to read English version because sometimes I want to read in English version. So now, without any thinking, I'm just reading it through. Or reading is more easy to me. Sometimes the pronunciation is not just correct, but it's almost similar. So that's why I'm choosing and reading chapter Genesis. I love Genesis chapter 1, verse 1. In the beginning, God created the heaven and the earth. Some versions, you know, heavens and the earth. But I already think about there are the heaven. King James Holy Bible described the heaven and the earth. But you remember, if you just meditate about what kind of heaven or heavens like that, you can choose your own version. It's a good idea for me and for you too. But if you know more specific science, maybe you can describe which heaven or heavens. So include all universe, include the Earth too. So if we know the solar system, there will be heavens. But though we don't know now, I don't know exactly, but include all the whole universe, we will call the heavens. But just only the earth, only one heaven. So we'll read first. In the beginning, God created the heavens and the earth, because this one is also King James Version, Old and New Testament, the King James Version. Yes, so there are heavens. Heavens and the earth. Let's together read. In the beginning, God created the heavens and the earth. The earth was without form and void, and darkness was on the face of the deep, and the Spirit of God was hovering over the face of the waters. We have to know. I love the verse 2 also, because we know this systematical verse, you can find more easily the God created from the basic, from this verse 2. So the hint is the form, without form, and then void. He just feared the form, that form. And the darkness need light. And then the water, the divided water. So here are the material, the without form, the earth, and void. That also material to God. And then darkness still exists, darkness. God used that, you know, darkness too. And then the water, the Holy Spirit, just, you know, hovering the faith of the waters. So also the God used that waters too. So you just, if you just think about that, you can find it more the funny, you know, creation worked with God. So verse 3, then God said, let there be light, and there was light. And God saw the light, that it was good, and God divided the light from the darkness. Verse 5, God called the light day, and the darkness he called the night. So the evening and the morning were the first day. So he called the first day. Always he just said first, let there be light. And there was light. Yeah. And God saw always, you know, the first work, and then saw the light, that it was good. And he just always, you know, said it was good. And God divided the light from the darkness. Here, you see the darkness, divide the light. God called the light day, and the darkness he called night. So the evening, and the evening is first. The evening, because the darkness comes already existed. So God respect kind of the material darkness, and then he just first the evening is more first than the morning. So that's the, he called the first day. Yeah, if you understand like this, you know, second day and to the seventh day, like that. So I don't more explain about that, because I want to read it through first, but I talked lots of, you know, time. I don't want to waste your time, but like me, you just, you know, the understanding, you already knew it, but somebody who doesn't know yet how to read the Bible, so that's why I'm just, you know, explain about that. Then God said, let there be, verse 5, God called the light day, and the darkness he called night. So the evening and the morning were the first day. Verse 6, then God said, let there be a firmament in the midst of the waters, yeah, here, midst of the waters, and let it divide the waters from the waters. And then number 7, thus God made the firmament and divided the waters which were under the firmament from the waters which were above the firmament, and it was so. Verse 8, and God called the firmament to heavens, so the evening and the morning were the second day. 9, then God said, let the water under the heavens be gathered together into the place, and let the dry land appear, and it was so. Verse 10, and God called it dry land, earth, and the gathering together of the waters he called seas, and God saw that it was good. Number 11, then God said, let the earth bring forth grass, Yeah, first to bring forth grass, the herb that yields seed and the fruit tree, that yields fruit according to its kind, those whose seed is in itself, on the earth, and it was so. 12. And the earth brought forth grass, the herb that yields seed according to its kind, and the tree that yields fruit whose seed is in itself according to its kind, and God that it was good. Verse 13. So the evening and the morning were the third day. Verse 14, then God said, let there be light in the firmament of the heavens to divide the day from the night, and let them be for signs and seasons, and for days and years. Yeah, because of the sun and moon and stars, only for the sign. Let them be for the signs and the seasons and for days and years. So, if you remind the stars and moons and sun, the solar kind of solar system will be make a sign. So it's if you want to about your time. The need we have to know the kind of sign. So it is really important, not only for the light and darkness, but for the more important in God's sight, the sign between the creator and creature. Yeah. And then God said that there be light in the firmament of the heavens to divide the day from the night, and let them be for signs and seasons and for days and years. Verse 15, and let them be for lights in the firmament of the heavens to give light on the earth, and it was so. 16. Then God made two great lights, the greater light to rule the day and the lesser light to rule the night. He made the stars also. God set them in the firmament of the heavens to give light on the earth, and to rule over the day and over the night, and to divide the light from the darkness. And God saw that it was good. So the evening and the morning were the fourth day. Then God said, let the waters abound with an abundance of living creatures, and let birds fly above the earth across the face of the firmament of the heavens. 21. So God created great sea creatures and every living thing that moves with which the waters abounded according to their kind, and every winged bird according to its kind. And God saw that it was good, and God blessed them, saying, be fruitful. Yeah, sometimes I'm just reading with word by word. It's more good for you, but I'm just take video on my face, because eye contact is good for me and you, so that's why. And then I wanna compare with the King James Bible version, the other one. Sometimes I'm I was so surprised if I compare with other version, more we can understand the Bible, the words of God. But Holy Spirit always give us to understand the word of God. So I need to pray first. Holy Spirit, please help me, because this time I'm just, you know, come from my daughter's apartment with my husband. There are kind of something. So I need to have calm my mind. So I don't know how to do. I don't know where I go. Then if I just read the Bible, really good to me. So that's why I'm trying to read first. Next time, if I read more, and then if I, yeah, without any thinking, I just ask to Holy Spirit, and then I can do it. But not now. I need more calm down my heart. So I want to reading. Yeah, it's better way. So the need more, one more, because the verse by verse is good to read again and again, because almost 39 years, during 39 years, I just read the not just lots of, you know, times, but sometimes, several times I read the Genesis, but I still forget all of, you know, things, but only I just guess the contents, story. But I want more specifically know. So I want to read it again. I want to read it, repeat and again and again. So repeating is really good. Though we can't memorize all of them, but repeat and then thinking about the 22, verse 22, and God blessed them saying, be fruitful, and multiply and fill the waters in the seas, and let birds multiply on the earth. 23, so the evening and the morning were the fifth day. 24, then God said, let the earth bring forth the living creature. You know, the earth bring forth the living creature according to its kind, cattle, and creeping thing, and beast of the earth, each according to its kind. And it was so. Sometimes the singular, plural of word is so interesting to me. So if we just compare with other version, it's more interesting to you too. So, and 25th, and God made the beast of the earth according to its kind, cattle according to its kind, and everything that creeps on the earth according to its kind. And God saw that it was good. 26, then God said, let us make man in our image according to our kind likeness, let them have dominion over the fish or the sea, over the birds of the air, and over the cattle, over all the earth and over every creeping thing that creeps on the earth. 28, so God created man in his own image, in the image of God, he created him, male and female, he created them. So though the chapter 1 is not long, you know, chapter, just, you know, verse 31, but God God described all the short verses, he described two or three times the let there be light, and it was, and more specifically, maybe Moses explained about God's creation work. So specifically, one more repeating is really good. If this is the news article, it's too long. Maybe they described more phrase, more sentence like that, but it's really short. Yeah, short, but all creation work is make the concentrate like that. So God created man, verse 27. God created man in his own image. In the image of God, he created him, male and female, he created them. 28, then God blessed them. This is important to us. Then God blessed them, and God said to them, be fruitful and multiply, fill the earth and subdue it, have dominion over the fish of the sea, over the birds of the air, and over every living thing that that moves on the earth. That's the really great, you know, blessing for the man and woman. We just dominion over the fishy, the fruitful and multiplying. We have to fruitful, multiply, and fill the earth and subdue it, have dominion over the fish of the fish, over the birds of the air, and over every living thing that moves on the earth. We have to know this, our authority for us. God gave us authorities for us. And actually, he created all of others for me. Yeah, for you. So we have to know this is the basic. Yeah, 29, and God said, see, I have given you every herb that yields seed which is on the face of all the earth, and every tree whose fruit yields seed to you it shall be for food. 30, also to every beast of the earth, to every bird of the air, and to everything that creeps on the earth in which there is life, I have given every green herb for food, and it was so. 31, then God saw everything that he had made, and indeed it was very good. So the evening and the morning were the sixth day. Yeah. So all the things were done. But the chapter 6, God gave us the good blessing, nice blessing for us. Yeah. Thus, chapter 2, verse 1, thus the heavens and the earth and all the host of them were finished. And on the seventh day, God ended his work which he had done, and he rested on the seventh day from all his work which he had done. Verse 3, then God blessed. This is also their blessing. So it is important to verse. Blessed the seventh day and sanctified it. Yeah, even sanctified it. Because in it he rested from all his work which God had created and made. Verse 4, this is the history of the heavens and the earth when they were created in the day that the Lord God made the earth and the heavens. 5. Before any plant of the field was the earth, and before any herb of the field had grown, for the Lord God had not caused it to rain on the earth, and there was no man to till the ground. 6. But a mist went up from the earth and watered the whole face of the ground. 7. And the Lord God formed man of the dust of the ground and breathed into his nostrils and breath of life, and man became a living being. 8. The Lord God planted garden earth eastward in Eden, and there he put the man whom he had formed. 9. And out of the ground the Lord God made every tree. 17. But of the tree of the knowledge of good and evil you shall not eat, for in the day that you eat of it you shall surely die. Yeah, 17, verse 17, there are the tree of knowledge and good and evil you shall not eat, for in the day that you eat of it you shall surely die. 18. And the Lord God said, it is not good that man should be alone. I will make him a helper comparable to him. Helper comparable to him. 19. Out of the ground the Lord God formed every beast of the field, that every bird of the air, and brought them to Adam to see what he would call them, and Adam called each living creature, even living creature that was his name. So smart. 20. So Adam gave names to all cattle, to the birds of the air, and to every beast of the field, but for Adam there was not found a helper comparable to him. 21. And the Lord God caused a deep sleep to fall on Adam, and he slept, and he took one of his ribs and closed up the flesh in its place. 22. Then the rib which the Lord God had taken from man he made into a woman, and he brought her to the man. 23. And Adam said, this is now bone of my bones and flesh of my flesh. She shall be called woman, because she was taken out of man. 24 is the last verse of chapter 2. Therefore a man shall leave his father and mother, and he joined to his wife, and they shall become one flesh. 25th is the last one. And they were both naked, the man and his wife, and were not ashamed. So I finished the chapter 2. So it takes only maybe 10 minutes. It's not takes 10 minutes, but I just talk a lot, little bit more, put my words. But you have your own, you know, words. You have your own thinking. So today, I live 39, you know, years with my husband. Sometimes we quarrel. Sometimes we have just to talk strongly. But today, I just come because of the morning meal. Yeah. So he's gonna be cook now for the daughter's family. Good. Yeah. Next time I will tell more thoroughly. So anyway, I come to my place and just reading it. Yeah. Thank you. See you again. Wow. Yeah, battery is still left, so I will read through chapter 3. Now the servant was more cunning than any beast of the field which the Lord God had made. And he said to the woman, has God indeed said, you shall not eat of every tree of the garden? And the woman said to the serpent, we may eat the fruit of the trees of the garden, chapter 2, and verse 2, and verse 3, but of the fruit of the tree which is in the midst of the garden, God has said, you shall not eat it, nor shall you touch it, lest you die. Yeah, God. Not like that. Verse 4. And the serpent said to the woman, you will not surely die. 5. For God knows that in the day you eat of it, your eyes will be opened, and you will be like God, knowing good and evil. Verse 6. So when the woman so that the tree was good for food, that it was pleasant to the eyes, and a tree desirable to make one wise, she took of its fruit and ate. She also gave to her husband with her, and he ate. Then the eyes of both of them were opened, and they knew that they were naked, and they sewed fig trees together and made themselves coverings. And they heard the sound of the Lord God walking in the garden in the cool of the day, and Adam and his wife hid themselves from the presence of the Lord God among the trees of the garden. Then the Lord God called to Adam and said to him, where are you? So he said, I heard your voice in the garden, and I was afraid because I was naked, and I hid myself. And he said, who told you that you were naked? Have you eaten from the tree of which I commanded you that you should not eat? Then the man said, the woman whom you gave to be with me, she gave me of the tree, and I ate. And the Lord God said to the woman, what is this you have done? And the woman said, the serpent deceived me, and I ate. So the Lord God said to the serpent, Because you have done this, you are cursed more than all cattle and more than every beast of the field. On your belly you shall go, and you shall eat dust all the days of your life. And I will put enmity between you and the woman, and between your seed and her seed. He shall bruise your head, and you shall bruise his heel. To the woman he said, I will greatly multiply your sorrow and your conception in pain. You shall bring forth children. Your desire shall be for your husband, and he shall rule over you. Then to Adam he said, Because you have heeded the voice of your wife and have eaten from the tree of which I commanded you, saying, You shall not eat of it. Cursed is the ground for your sake. In toil you shall eat of it all the days of your life. Both thorns and thistles it shall bring forth for you, and you shall eat the herb of the field. In the sweat of your face you shall eat bread till you return to the ground, for out of it you were taken, for dust you are, and to dust you shall return. And Adam called his wife wife's name Eve, because she was the mother of all living. Also for Adam and his wife, the Lord God made tunics of skin and clothed them. Then the Lord God said, Behold, the man has become like one of us to know good and evil, and now lest he put out his hand and take also of the tree of life and eat and live forever. Therefore, the Lord God sent him out of the Garden of Eden to till the ground from which he was taken. So he drove out the man, and he placed the cherubim at the east of the Garden of Eden, and a flaming sword which turned every way to guard the way to the life of life. God, the tree of life. I wanna read until the fourth, but the battery just almost gone, so I'll try. Yeah. Because chapter 1 and 2 is the creation work, and then from the chapter 3, the fallen, the human, degradation of the mankind. Humankind. So from the chapter 4, the our pre-ancestors first starting. So I'll try to read through so quickly. Go. Now Adam knew Eve, his wife, and she conceived and bore Cain, and said, I have gotten a man from the Lord. Right. Then she bore again, this time his brother Abel. Now Abel was a keeper of sheep, but Cain was a tiller of the ground. And in the process of time it came to pass that Cain brought an offering of the fruit of the ground to the Lord. Abel also brought of the first things of his flock and of their fat, and the Lord respected Abel and his offering. But he did not respect Cain and his offering. And Cain was very angry, and his countenance, and Cain was countenance fair. Yeah, God respect if even the creatures the if they obey, he respect us, and then the if we not obey, the our countenance will be fair paid. So the Lord said to Cain, why are you angry, and why has your countenance fallen? If you do well, will you not be accepted?
Okay. And I want to read my Bible, chapter 4. I come to cultural center, the youth room. It's so cool. I can see the watch out the trees. Chapter 4. Now Adam knew Eve, his wife, and she conceived and bore Cain and said, I have gotten a man from the Lord. Then she bore again, this time his brother Abel. Now Abel was a creeper of sheep, but Cain was a tiller of the ground. Verse 3, and in the process of time it came to pass that Cain brought an offering of the fruit of the ground to the Lord. For Abel also brought of the firstlings of his flock and of their fat, and the Lord respected Abel and his offering. Verse 5, but he did not respect Cain and his offering, and Cain was very angry, and his countenance fell. Verse 6, so the Lord said to Cain, why are you angry, and why has your countenance fallen? 7, if you do well, will you not be accepted? And if you do not do well, sin lies at the door, and its desire is for you, but you should rule over it. 8. Now Cain talked with Abel his brother, and it came to pass when they were in the field that Cain rose again Abel his brother and killed him. Verse 9, then the Lord said to Cain, where is Abel your brother? And he said, I do not know. Am I my brother's keeper? 10. And he said, what have you done? The voice of your brother's blood cries but to me from the ground. 11. So now you are cursed from the earth, which has opened its mouth to receive your brother's blood from your hand. 12. When you tear the ground, it shall no longer yield its strength to you. A fugitive and a vagabond you shall be on the earth. 13. And Cain said to the Lord, my punishment is greater than I can bear. 14. Surely you have driven me out this day from the face of the ground. I shall be hidden from your face. I shall be a fugitive and a vagabond on the earth. And it will happen that anyone who finds me will kill me. 15. And the Lord said to him, therefore, Lord said to him too. Just here. You can write on the Bible. It's good. Sometimes I just to write here the my beloved names, family names, church members, and the who I know, and then the prayer for the at that time, if I need the kind of prayer, I just do right here. And then if I ask, if I have any question, I make the question here. Yeah. So if you do that, it's good for you. Whoever cares came, and 15, and the Lord said to him, therefore, whoever kills Cain, vengeance shall be taken on him sevenfold. And the Lord said, a mark on Cain, lest anyone finding him should kill him. God answered this kind of evil doer's prayer too. So anyway, the prayer is answered, but especially we will do the right and good things, then it will be more blessing from the above. Then Cain, 16, then Cain went out from the presence of the Lord and dwelt in the land of Nod on the east of Eden. 17, and Cain knew his wife, and she conceived and bore Enoch. And he built a city and called the name of the city after the name of his son Enoch. 18, to Enoch was born Irad, and Irad begot Mushir, and then Mushir begot Muhuzer begot Methuselah, and Methuselah begot Lamech. And then 19, then Lamech took for himself two wives. The name of one was Adar, and the name of the second was Zillah. 20, and Adar bore Jeber. He was the father of those who dwell in tents and have livestock. 21, his brother's name was Yubal. He was the father of all those who played the harp and flute. 22, and as so for Zillah, she also bore Tubal-Cain, an instructor of every craftsman in bronze and iron. And the sister and Tubal-Cain was Nama. The 23, then Nama said to his wives, Adar and Zillah, hear my voice, O wives of Lamech, listen to my speech, for I have killed a man for wounded, wounding me, even a young man for hurting me. 24, if Cain shall be avenged sevenfold, then Lamech 77-fold. Yeah, his grandson will be more covered, protected by God 77-fold. Yeah. That's the avenged, yeah, not the protecting, avenged sevenfold, 774. It's gonna be turned to blessing, I guess. 25, and Adam knew his wife again, and she bore a son and named him Seth. For God has appointed another seed for me instead of Abel, whom Cain killed. 26, and as for Seth, to him also a son was born, and he named him Enos. Then men began to call on the name of the Lord. From that time, the people just began to call on the name of the Lord. Chapter 5. Yeah, I'm gonna go through quickly. This is the book of the genealogy of Adam. In the day that God created man, he made him in the likeness of God. Verse 2, he created them male and female, and blessed them and called them mankind. In the day they were created, and Adam lived 130 years, and begot a son in his own likeness, after his image, and named him Seth. After he begot Seth, the days of Adam were 800 years, and he begot sons and daughters. So all the days that Adam lived were 930 years, and he died. Seth lived 105 years, and begot Enos. After he begot Enos, Seth lived 807 years, and begot sons and daughters. All the days of Seth were 912 years, and he died. Enos lived 90 years, and begot Canaan. After he begot Canaan, Enos lived 815 years, and begot sons and daughters. So all the days of Enos were 905 years, and he died. 12. Canaan lived 70 years and begot Mahalalel. After he begot Mahalalel, Canaan lived 840 years and begot sons and daughters. So all the days of Canaan were 910 years, and he died. Mahalalel lived 65 years and begot Jared. After he begot Jared, Mahalalel lived 830 years and begot sons and daughters. So all the days of Mahalalel were 895 years, and he died. Jared lived 162 years and begot Enoch. After he begot Enoch, Jared lived 800 years and begot sons and daughters. So all the days of Jared were 962 years, and he died. Enoch lived 65 years and begot Methuselah. After he begot Methuselah, Enoch walked with God 300 years and begot sons and daughters. So all the days of Enoch were 365 years, and Enoch walked with God, and he was not, for God took him. Methuselah lived 187 years and begot Lamech. After he begot Lamech, Methuselah lived 782 years and begot sons and daughters. So all the days of Methuselah were 969 years, and he died. Lamech lived 182 years and begot a son, and he called his name Noah, saying, This one will comfort us concerning our work and toil of our hands because of the ground which the Lord has cursed. After he begot Noah, Lamech lived 595 years and begot sons and daughters. So all the days of Lamech were 777 years, and he died. And Noah was 500 years old, and Noah begot Sem, Ham, and Japheth. 와서 제가 놀고 있습니다. 애들하고 같이. 동네 애들 놀이터입니다. 뉴스 시네마 카페 엘리너스 난디스티디스. 더 이상 혼자가 아니다. 뭐가 이렇게 많이 나야 됐네요. 꿈을 여기다가 다 적어놨네. 재밌네. 재밌는 아이디어. 저기 또 밖에 화장실 있고. 그럼 나갈 수, 나갈 수 있네. 애들, 밖에 보여. 애들 놀이터가 있네. 거기가 우리 아파트가 여기서 다 보이네. 네. 바람도 시원하고 또 오늘도 이렇게 성경 읽으러 왔는데 이렇게 보고 있네. 전자레인지도 있고 맛있는 거 먹을 수 있게 다 해놨네. 아주 재밌는 아이디어. 봉사 재밌네. 5월 30일 수질인다 영화제. 영화제가 있네. 모두의 뉴스 카페. 모두에게 알려주세요. 아이디가 있어야 하니까 초등학교 5학년부터 고3까지 열려있는 공간인데요. 너무 재밌는 게 여기 긍정적인 말의 힘을, 말 한마디로 청량빛 감는다 말의 힘을 직접 체험해보는데, 여기는 사랑해, 사랑해 너무 예뻐 하고 이렇게 적어놓으니까 고구마에 싹이 났어요. 근데 이게 짜증나, 너무 미워. 그러니까 진짜 고구마에 아무것도 안 났네. 야, 1월달 50일 이렇게 했는데 정말 그랬네요. 어떻게 이런 일이 있을 수 있을까요? 짜증나 그렇다고 아무것도 다 씨가 다 말랐네요. 어떡하지? 미안하다. 네가 실험 대상이라 이러는구나. 미안해. 싹이 나고 한번 꽃이 싹이 나보렴. 내가라도 이렇게 해줄게. 말해줄게. 그래 미안하다. 싹이 좀 나와버려. 사랑해 너무너무 예뻐. 사랑해 너무너무 예뻐 하니까 이렇게 났어요. 싹이 신비롭게. 사랑해 너무너무 예뻐. 2015년 1월 20일 화요일부터 시작한 건데 1월달이면은 지금 5월 말이니까 어떻게 이런 일이 있을 수 있을까요? 사랑해 해야 되겠네요. 그죠? 오늘 저도 마음이 사랑해 하지 않고 이렇게 사춘기 소녀처럼 나와서 성경 읽고 그러는데 너무 실물교 오늘 저한테 보여주시네요.